Naravno. Vi kod svi idi sve na... Da se ti nešto ti često ti.
Pođi na.
In Hagen's of Vrindavan, after the Shia talked to Krishna, then they start
starting the name of Vishnu. And they also, when gopis were searching for Krishna, and they met Krishna disguised himself as an Narayan. He exhibited two more hands, and then gopis met Krishna, and then met Narayan, and they offered their obeisances to Narayan, and then asked him, could you please tell us where is Krishna? So but we know, as a theory, we know that Krishna and Narayana are not different. But here we can see also that there is difference, that Vrijbasi are seeing difference. Does someone has any idea what is this difference, what Vrijbasi are seeing in between Krishna and Narayana? Yes?
This Madhurya aspect, the sweetness.
Mm-hmm. Someone has some little, yes.
He's got four arms, Krishna has four arms.
Mm-hmm. Yes, this is also one.
Krishna has a flute.
Yeah, there are these four things which are making difference from Krishna to Narayan. Mm. So one of them is that he's playing flute. One of them is that he has very nice relationship with his devotees. One is that he's so beautiful.
He smiles
beautiful. But otherwise, you know, it also says in the Shastras that who see difference in between Krishna and Narayan, that he will go in hell. How is that in one side we have four differences in between Krishna and Narayan, and another side we should not see differences in between Krishna and Narayan? Yes?
Think
about it. Just recently I heard something which could be a little bit understood. So what I heard in one class, that if you look from the point of the tattva, there is no difference. But if you look from the point of rasa, then there is difference. So, I mean, it is a chintapedabhyanta, because it is difference from one side, it's not from another one. But if we look all from tattva side, you know, Krishna is Narayan, actually Narayan is Krishna, and Krishna is Narayan when he dressed up nicely. All these qualities. He put two more hands, he put so much nice golden decoration, everything. And when he is as Krishna, he is just cowherd boy running in Vrindavan, playing with boys, getting dirty, and then his mother has to take bath, has to bathe him, and she has to feed him and everything else. But Narayan is the, and then all this service with Mother Yashoda and other people from Vrindavan and giving to Krishna, this is all which gives all this taste, all this rasa, nice relationships. Because Lord Narayan and Vishnu, they are not having this kind of relationships with his devotees. His devotees are coming and worshipping him, offering obeisances, offering nice prayers, and everything goes in very official mood. It's very nice, but it's different. But with Krishna, there is all this personal rasa. Cowherd boys are jumping on his back, gopis are fighting him with him, always having some arguments, and most of the times Radharani is always even winning in these battles. And he also allowed to cowherd boys to beat him in wrestling matches and everything. So this is very, very different, very sweet exchange. And sometimes it's compared also when father is playing with the small son. And then he allows to the son sometimes to win. And then son's coming to the, yeah, you see, I'm stronger than the father. But it doesn't mean that son is really stronger than the father, because if father wants, you know, he can really smash the child, and then the child is laying down in blood and everything else. But this is not, you know, way how father is playing with the child. So in the same way, you know, Krishna is playing with his other friends, and by the way, he is also in Maya. It's not that he is pretending, that he just purposely giving them to be a little bit stronger than him, and he's a little bit hungry, so mother has to feed him. No, because this Maya, yoga potency, yoga Maya, not Maha Maya in which we are here in material world, this is yoga Maya. This yoga Maya is helping him to have all these nice pastimes with his devotees. So he forgets, but in the influence of this yoga Maya, he forgets that he is Supreme Personality of Godhead, and he's just playing with his friends and enjoying very nice time. And what they are doing, and what we as a aspiring Vaishnava are trying to do, we are just, like what we had this nice kirtan down there. So why we are having these nice kirtans? Why are we discussing philosophy and doing all these things? Does someone has any? Yes? Yes, yes, that's one of the answers. Either suggestions?
And to never forget Krishna.
Yes, Maharaj.
To help to awaken our generous love for Krishna.
Oh, yes. Help. Did you have some suggestion?
Glorify Krishna, kirtan, prayer,
practice. Yes. Yes. But one thing which we definitely... You have one more? What I was thinking is, we are doing all these things to please Krishna. Everybody agree? Yeah. Because many of these other motives which we can have, we don't want to do anything for our motives. It's nice, you know, while we are doing all these things, we get purified. This is very good and auspicious. But this is not goal of all these things what we are doing, because this is kind of selfish goal, maybe very, very high, not gross selfish goal, but it's still selfish that we become purified. But when they're doing things for his pleasure, then it's just for him. This is how our service is supposed to be, unmotivated, not have any motivation for ourselves, just to please Krishna. And, yes?
Can I ask a question?
Yes.
So is it... Saying that our service should be at that point, but we have to go through the purificatory stage before we come to that stage. Is that correct? Or are you saying we can be in the impure state? We can not go through the purification and still be performing devotional service.
Devotional service is if you're doing for the pleasure of the Krishna. So even if you are not pure or something, you can still, when you're coming down, I don't know, you can say, okay, now I'm going to sing, but I'm going to sing for pleasure of the Krishna. Not because I like singing and I need some now nice time, I'm going to sing with my friends and we will enjoy and have a nice time. Or guests are coming, so let's entertain the guest. Or I don't know, you can have different ideas. Why to sing? But if your idea, why I'm going to sing? I'm going to sing for the pleasure of Krishna. He's standing down there. I mean, even if not, he is in this pillar here. So still, we can pretend to be sick. Still, you know, still if you have this attitude, you are, whatever you're going to do, you are going to do for the pleasure of the Krishna. You know, even when you're going to take prasadam, you can think, okay, I'm going to take this for the pleasure of the Krishna. Because we can see when Krishna came as a Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he was distributing prasadam around. He take big happiness in watching devotees are taking prasadam. And he is the one who gave us little bit more insight into this, what Krishna likes, what Krishna doesn't like, what is for his pleasure or not. So we can see, when you are now, when breakfast coming, half an hour, you can think, oh no, I'm so hungry, you know, I'm looking forward to this broccoli or whatever is coming. Or you can take, no, I'm going now to take this prasadam just for Krishna's pleasure. Because he's happy that I'm taking prasadam, not something, other kind of food.